It'll get a lot harder the next 19 before Mountain West Conference tournament play, and that's what we told our team. I also told them that the last three games that we've held three teams under 40 points, we've done it in a fashion that wins no matter who you play. It wasn't wild, crazy stuff, one-on-one. It was team basketball at both ends of the floor, and that's what pleased me the most. The unselfishness that we had. We had 16 first half assists and wound up with 27 for the game on 43 free throws. That's pretty good. That's a willingness to say, if you're open, you'll get the ball. And it lends itself to fun, enjoyable basketball. And I told the last group of guys that got in, so often when you put guys in that are not on scholarship, that don't get hardly any time, it turns into that. But they epitomize what the whole game was like and what the last few games have been like. They did a great job of moving the ball, and it felt good. So I think we're making progress. I leaned over to Dutch one time and said, Winston looks much more under control and confident when he goes into the basket rather than he now thinks it's going in rather than hoping it's going in. So a lot of progress I saw there, and we need to make sure that we get Josh back. He had all of his four wisdom teeth pulled on Monday. They were impacted and needed to do it, so this was the best time. So he'll be back at practice hopefully tomorrow. Dakari sprained his ankle, but he's okay, according to Tom. He hopefully will be back tomorrow. And we're hoping that De'Aaron, we did an MRI today, and everything was fine. So we're hoping that we can do something to help him get able to be back to play. So we're 10-1, and that's, we're pleased with our record and excited about league play. And we all know, especially the guys that have been there before, that nothing comes easy, especially on the road. So we'll be ready on January 1st. I know Colorado State will be too. So it should be a wonderful kickoff for us for league play. Anything? They got it? I've liked our togetherness, our willingness to be a good teammate. I think we've got great depth, and that's shown itself. When some guys have been hurt, other guys that haven't gotten a lot of time have performed. And you can start with AQ and Poli, who had games where they didn't play at all. And now you say, maybe we better find ways to get them more time. So we still need to get better with our rebounding. Our defensive rebounding is something that should take strides to be better. We've worked at it. We've talked about it. Got to make sure we don't have careless turnovers. Even though we had 11, I thought we had four or five that have to be eliminated. And then I think we shot under 60% from the free throw line. You got to step the line and make your free throws. So we got a lot to work on. But we got a pretty good group to work with, and we're in a pretty good position as we work to move forward. We're not on the bottom rung of the ladder in terms of where we are with our team, but we got a lot more that I think we can climb on to get better, which is also nice.
If anything, did you learn about your team without Josh Davis in there? I mean, I know, the opponent wasn't quite where you're going to be playing in the conference, but what did you just think about your team's play with that?
We played a lot of different lineups in combination because of injury or illness. And again tonight, without Josh, who's our best rebounder, who had 17 rebounds in the last game, we were good. I know J.J. O'Brien's anxious to get that pad off his hand, and we're hopeful that he'll play without it in our next game. and I know that would be pleasing to JJ. So, but I think every game you say, well, okay, who can do what? And when one guy can't play, it gives somebody else an opportunity. So it gave guys opportunities to play that might not got, that for sure wouldn't have got as many minutes had we had everybody healthy, had Josh been able to play.
You didn't play JJ in the last game. What was the thinking behind playing him tonight? Has he shown that much improvement with his hand that it's okay?
I'm a good listener. And when I talked to him last time, I could sense that he had a concern about his hand. And I said, well, what do you think? Would you rather not play? And he said, well, maybe. I said, well, we won't play you then. And I said, how you doing? He said, I talked to him on Christmas. How's it feel? A lot better. I want to play. I'll be ready to play on against St. Catherine's. So I played him because he wanted to play. Tom said, even in the last game, Tom didn't think it would hurt him to play, but I thought he was a little tentative and it might be better not to play him. He wanted to play today, and Tom co-signed it. So, and I'm hoping that he'll play and play effectively without the pad, brace, whatever it is on his hand next game. That got it?
Do you take any pride in the deficit setting that mark?
Do I take what?
Do you take any pride or happiness home in setting the mark for biggest deficit in victory?
I like the fact that we've held three straight teams under 40 points. First time Mike May told me since 2000 that anybody has done that. And you might say, well, look who you've played. And I would come right back and say, look how we've played. We've played in a fashion that wins, no matter whether we're playing St. Catharines or Duke. And hopefully we will play with that same type of togetherness and energy for the next 19 games leading up to the conference tournament.